Kaya Heller. I'm second captain on Sundiver and also a paddy instructor. I've been working on the boat for about 5 years now. Pretty much the happiest time of my life. Captain Ray, the owner of Sundiver, has a saying that there are worse offices in the world than being on the boat. We get to see a lot of amazing things. Really, the heart of Sundiver is Captain Ray's deep love of diving, specifically here in Southern California, and his desire to share it with people that will appreciate it and value it too. We've been real determined throughout this time to make Sundiver as close to a yacht quality dive boat as possible. And then, of course, I actually did my first dive off this boat at Santa Barbara Island with hundreds of sea lions swirling around me, and actually climbed back up and sat down on the center island and thought to myself that this is what I'd been looking for 32 years, and basically poured all my resources into going straight through becoming a paddy instructor. And after I made instructor, I really wanted to go back and work in the industry to learn how to dive master, to learn how to take care of divers. The more I saw about other operations, the more I was drawn to this boat and learning how this boat runs and operates. Diver safety is probably the most important thing, followed closely by diver comfort. We like our heads to appeal to 20-something young women who've never been on a boat before. We like them to be comfortable and warm and have showers and clean facilities. As far as instructing, I love introducing new people to California water. I think this is one of the best places to train. It's not as challenging as the North Sea or Puget Sound or certainly the East Coast, but if you can dive competently in these waters, when you go to the Caribbean or to the warm water destinations, you're automatically going to be really comfortable. Also, some basic wonderful things about Southern California diving. California has very young geology, which lends itself to walls and swim-throughs and pinnacles and caves. Our lobster population here is healthy and well-maintained, and there are times you'll stick your head into a crack and there'll be 50 tiny lobster panicking at your bubbles and your intrusion. And I've seen things just off the scale in these waters. I've seen one crab whose back shell, still alive, really, really old dinosaur crab, his back shell was at least 3 feet across. His tiny little tip claws were bigger than my hands. Our sea lions at Santa Barbara are just outrageously funny. I've had 30 or 40 of them swirling around me in the water at once. And actually we have, there are some videos up that were taken off Sundiver that one of them is called Attack of the Killer Sea Lions. And that's a joke, of course, because our sea lions don't attack you. But it's set to ominous music, and the number of these creatures that you can go play with in relatively temperate water in fairly safe, protected bays, it's mind-blowing, and I think it would be a once-in-a-lifetime experience for a lot of people. For the future of Sundiver, we're really looking to expand the types of boats we have. We currently have the big boat, Sundiver itself, and we have a 33-foot rescue-configured crystal liner that's really a wonderful elite diving, elite research vessel. We're looking to include another high-occupancy fast vessel so we can help people reach and enjoy some of these amazing ecosystems. Of course, our other landmark thing in California is our kelp forests. There's nothing quite like swimming through golden amber vertical stalks and the sun slanting down and over this just beautiful terrain with Garibaldi lunging at you because they're trying to protect their nests. And if you don't know, Garibaldi are these, they look like they should be in a tropical fishbowl somewhere. The males groom their nests, and they're fairly aggressive, but they have no teeth, or very small teeth, and no real way of hurting you, but they will go out of their way to protect their nests. And the number of species that we see routinely here is fabulous. These are very rich, very living waters. Captain Ray really believes that this is one of the best places in the world to die. That's why he runs boats here. And the more I travel, actually, the more I agree with him. I've been to beautiful warm water destinations, and I find myself missing the kelp and missing the big animals. And it lends huge variety to our trips, because we can plan any assortment of trips. We can plan trips that are all concentrating on local wrecks, that concentrate on the oil rigs, that concentrate on pretty much any part of the Channel Islands, which of course is a vast territory in itself. We can go to easy teaching spots that are geared towards beginning divers, where they'll still see beautiful things and lots of wildlife. We can go to do really advanced deep diving. We can even do tech diving if we have the right kind of group. So the ability to be with Sundiver and really learn as a new captain is invaluable.